Hey there, fellow scientists, Justin here, and I have an announcement. I have decided that I'm going to build my very own rocket ship to send myself into outer space. I want to study the stars and hop from planet to planet, but got to admit, I have no idea where to start when it comes to building rocket pieces. Like, what kinds of materials do I need? Well, scientists and innovators have always relied on their knowledge of the properties of matter in order to be able to figure out what material is best for any job. So that sounds like a pretty good place to start. By the end of today's lesson, you will be able to identify and describe the properties of matter and tell the difference between physical and chemical properties. Let's get into it. What is a property of matter? A property is a characteristic or trait that can be observed. Some examples: this chair is blue. This sandpaper is rough and bumpy. Hey, wait, you're matter, right? What kind of properties do you have? You might have just answered that question with the color of your hair, how tall you are, or maybe your shoe size. These are all great examples of what we call physical properties. A physical property of matter is a property that we can observe without changing the identity of the matter. So I can observe this chair, see that it's blue, and it's still the same chair after the fact. So you might have noticed that a lot of the physical properties we've talked about so far are things like color, shape, texture. But did you know that a lot of the things we've learned about in this unit are also physical properties? Yep, mass, volume, density, and state of matter are all physical properties as well. They can all be observed without changing the identity of the matter. Another physical property of matter is the temperature at which it changes states. State changes are a physical property because they don't change the identity of the matter. It's still the same matter, its atoms are just rearranged in a different way. The temperature at which matter changes from a liquid to a solid is called its freezing point. And the temperature at which it changes from a solid to a liquid is called its melting point. The freezing point and melting point, of course, are the same temperature. After all, it's the exact temperature at which that specific piece of matter would change state. For water, that temperature is 32 degrees Fahrenheit or 0 degrees Celsius. Anything below that temperature and water will freeze. Anything above that temperature and water, or really ice, will melt. The temperature at which matter changes from a liquid to a gas, or a gas to a liquid, is called its boiling or condensation point. That's 212 degrees Fahrenheit, or 100 degrees Celsius, for water. Different kinds of matter will have different melting and boiling points. For example, the oxygen gas that's in our atmosphere won't condense into a liquid unless it's really cold, like almost negative 300 degrees Fahrenheit. In case you're worried, the lowest temperature ever recorded outside on Earth was only negative 128 degrees Fahrenheit. So the oxygen gas around here will probably always be a gas. Phew! I gotta pay attention to when the materials I'm using for my rocket freeze or boil, shouldn't I? Another property of matter that I should pay attention to is something called solubility, or the ability for matter to dissolve. When matter dissolves, it breaks down into the smallest pieces of itself and becomes part of something else. For instance, some matter is soluble in water, meaning it will dissolve in it, and some matter isn't. For example, think of the last time you went to the beach. I bet you got sand everywhere. That's because sand is not soluble in water. It doesn't dissolve. Salt, on the other hand, is soluble. The salt in the ocean is dissolved, so you can't see it, and it's spread throughout the water. It doesn't settle on the seafloor like the sand does. I'll definitely keep solubility in mind when I'm building my rocket. But a physical property that's probably even more important than that has to do with magnetism. Magnetism is a force that attracts or repels certain materials. Whether or not an object is magnetic is a physical property. For example, iron, nickel, cobalt, and steel are all magnetic metals, meaning that magnets will attract them. So, the physical properties of matter are all the properties that we can observe without changing what the identity of the matter is. And trust me, there are tons more physical properties that we just haven't talked about. But what happens when the matter we're observing does change? Well, then we've got some chemical properties to observe. A chemical property is a characteristic that we can only observe when the matter changes into a new kind of matter. One of the ways that matter can change is through a chemical reaction. Reactivity is the chemical property of matter that describes how likely it is for a substance to react when it comes into contact with another substance. When matter reacts, it changes into a new kind of matter and energy is released. For instance, the metals on the end of a sparkler are highly reactive. When they come into contact with fire, they change into new substances and release light and heat in the form of sparks. Once we've observed that the sparkler is reactive, then the matter we started with has changed into something new. Another chemical property that you've probably seen before is the ability for something to rust. Some metals have a chemical reaction with water and oxygen in the atmosphere to create a new kind of matter, that red flaky stuff we call rust. Maybe that's something I should look into more as I'm finishing up my rocket. Flammability is another chemical property that is super important to know. Flammability describes how quickly matter will catch fire and burn. So as long as I pick a material that isn't flammable for the outside of my rocket, I should be good. Let's review what we've learned about the properties of matter. A physical property is a characteristic that can be observed without changing the identity of the matter. This includes properties like melting and boiling points, solubility, magnetism, and a whole lot more. A chemical property is a characteristic that can only be observed when matter changes into a new type of matter. These properties all come from chemical reactions, like rusting and flammability. To learn more about the properties of matter, be sure to check out the activities and practice questions for this lesson. And you should! Studying the properties of matter is how I was able to finish my rocket. I'm going to go explore the galaxy, but until next time, remember, science is all around us. See ya! Woo!